On the 24th of November, 1999, four of my colleagues never came home from work that day. Going to work that day, pretty much it was just a normal day. Light vehicle entering portal. On the day was a shutdown day, it was a planned shutdown day, and we've seen that during the course of the two or three days leading into the Wednesday, the muck pile height, so that broken rock, actually grew in height up towards maybe 70 to 80 metres, so we had quite a lot of material coming into the top of the extraction level from the cave. I went out onto the extraction level to have a look, and then at that point basically 3 o'clock, I was in the middle of the extraction level in drive four when the air blast happened. When that 14 or 16 million tonne failed into that void, where I was standing in the extraction level, there was an enormous floor heave. Felt like the floor probably lifted up about a foot, dropped back down, and then the draw points that were near me and in the area where I was basically were just instant dust. So couldn't see a thing, it was complete whiteout.
Good evening. Police have released the names of four men killed in a mining accident at Northparkes. It's believed the men were killed by an air blast caused by a cave-in.
The drillers would have been coming towards us at the time of the air blast, and it's picked their vehicle up. Would have got thrown around in this drive like a washing machine, got to this point where the intersection of the decline and one level, and it actually smashed their ute into multiple pieces, and parts went up the decline and parts went down the decline. They're saying that the range of the wind velocity was between 1,000 and 1,500 kilometres an hour. If you're in the path, you just had nothing you could do about it. The whole event went on for maybe 10 minutes.
I wasn't on site, but I'd not long graduated and I was just over in Orange at Cadia. So we heard about it quite quickly and it was a bit of a shock.
We've got a few people who were involved in the rescue efforts afterwards. So if you talk to them about the experience, it definitely is a very sobering thought.
Post the accident, there was a whole new focus. You know, the worst thing was it took an event like that to maybe shake some people up and change some opinions.
Some of the things that have changed at Northparkes since the incident are our management practices around risk. We have a TARP in place now, which is a trigger action response plan, which clearly defines what we have to monitor, what are the acceptable limits within what we monitor, and how we can react appropriately when we go outside of these acceptable limits. We've also got a cave management plan in place that we work to daily and we report to on a monthly basis.
We're sitting here with a very, very good team. The team here is not only committed, but also very, very focused on not only doing things the right way, but doing things in basically in a way that's pushing the edge towards zero harm. You know, why are we pushing for automation? Well, it's because we actually want people to not be in harm's way in the event something does occur.
Some of the things that we're working on are more information coming out of our cave monitoring. So we do cave monitoring, and there's some technologies that are developing to give us a better understanding of that, so better tracking of the cave backs and the muck pile within the ore.
The steps that we've taken and that we continue to take for each of our new block caves are directly learned from this incident.
A lot of people look to Northparkes as a leader in our management practices in terms of cave management. And it's definitely something that we're getting out there and talking about and putting into papers and trying to get advertised on a more worldwide scale.